a little present for you to give Hank.
Morning, Hank.
Morning, Corey.
Lassie's got a surprise for you.
Surprise? What do you know? Gumdrops. Thank you, Lassie. I'd like to visit with you, but I have to finish this mail.
Well, it's that time, Hank. When the ranger becomes the bookkeeper, purchasing agent, personnel manager, landlord, and all forms to be filled out in triplicate. Thanks.
You're welcome. You know, Corey, some people read the future in tea leaves, but I read coffee grounds.
Oh?
This morning I see a long trip for you, the very near future.
Oh?
What's a Gabian?
Reading coffee grounds. You've been reading my mail. Where's the orders? To proceed without delay to the Slavin River Gabian experimental project. There to make observations on the durability and efficiency and so forth. Yeah, the supervisor spoke to me about that last month. We're trying the Gabians in stream and river bank stabilization up in the upper Slavin.
It's very interesting. I'm impressed. But you still haven't answered my question. What is a Gabian?
It's an Italian invention. They use them for breakwaters, dam reinforcements, terraces, and things like that. Large woven baskets made of non-corrosive wire filled with rock. The wire is supposed to last about 20 years.
Yeah, and then what happens?
Well, the theory is that in that 20 years, the dirt that's washed downstream fills up the holes between the rocks. Plant life takes hold in the dirt, and the gabion becomes a solid permanent structure. Clear?
Sounds great. When do you leave?
The orders say, quote, without delay, unquote.
Today? Now? Well, who's going to do all this paperwork? The quarterly report, the requisitions, the timber sales.
You talk about reading coffee grounds. I think if you take a close look, you'll see who's going to do that paperwork. Come on, Lassie, and I won't forget my fishing rod.
Yeah, well, don't forget your swimming trunks and a few good books, too.
Stewart.
It must be Walt Ellsworth.
Right, right. Hello, Lassie.
How'd you know her name?
Oh, everybody in the Forest Service knows about Lassie.
Lassie, why don't you go get the kinks out of your legs? She's been cooped up in the cab of that truck an awful long time.
Hey, listen, Corey, you came over to check the gabions, didn't you? I got a map of the area in my truck. This is the Slavin River here, Corey. The closest point is about 15 miles up the main road. And the turnoff is on the secondary road. Now, the gabions run a 20-mile stretch down here. In fact, we're putting in a new section just about there. Now, the road runs right alongside. Easy access.
I'll take a look at it the first thing in the morning.
Good. Now, why don't you gather up your things and come out at the house for dinner?
Fine. I'll go find Lassie. Chow time. Got an invitation for dinner.
Well, how you coming, son?
What's the rifle for?
Well, there's just liable to be a few deer up where we're going.
Now, look, Dad, I agreed to come along on his fishing business, even though I have my doubts about it. But one thing I'm not going to do is hunt deer out of season or be any party to it.
Well, I didn't say anything about hunting, Frank. This is just in case one of those deer attacks us.
I mean it, Dad.
All right, all right. I didn't get up this hour of the morning to stand here and argue. Come on, it's a 40-mile drive up there.
Good, Walt.
Pull over there under cover, Frank. We're going the opposite direction. Let's
Well, according to the map, Lassie, this is where the first of the Gabions is built. You go get your feet wet while I put my boots on.
It's a nice looking pool, son. Let's get the waders out. Sure, a lot of rock in there, isn't there? Hold tight.
Stretch the net.
You take that end across, huh?
All right.
It's too hard over here. I'll just secure it with these rocks.
Okay.
Dad?
Yeah?
How loud is that thing when it goes off?
Well, between the small size of the charge and the shape of this river, you won't hear it over a quarter of a mile. $45 worth of fish, Frank. Go on, get the box. The other spot. That's all we need. Come on. All right, Frank, you start on the net, huh?
All right. Smelling salts in a medicine kit, Dad.
For a dog?
Well, why not?
Go ahead.
Probably come too without this stuff.
I don't care, just as long as she's all right.
Well, okay, she's all right. Let's get back to fish.
Lassie! Lassie!
That's sure a nice looking dog, Dad. I'm glad she's all right.
Pay attention to the net, Doctor.
Too hard, she's able to blow herself up.
All right, let's go.
Tried to kill that dog.
You want to get arrested for illegal fishing? That dynamite could be traced directly to me and the construction job. Do you want to get me fired?
Well, do you want the death of that dog on your conscience? I mean, she didn't make us come up here and dynamite fish, and she didn't make you take the dynamite. Why should she suffer for things that we've done wrong? Would you like that on your conscience?
Well, I guess he's a poor father who has to be reminded of moral values by his son. Isn't he?
Come on, let's go get the equipment.
Here, Lassie. Somebody's awfully careless with dynamite.
Come on, Lassie.
Yours?
That's mine.
I'll have to get in touch with Fish and Game. Don't leave. It'll just make matters worse than they are. KMB 577, this is Mobile 1. I found a couple of fellas dynamiting fish down by the South Fork Bridge. Get in touch with Fish and Game and have somebody come out here and pick them up. 10-4.
Feel pretty rotten, son. I talked you into this thing. I'll tell him so. Go on, Mike.
No, we did it together, and we'll make amends together. What do you think our punishment will be?
Well, I'm not the judge. It's a pretty serious offense. A lot of it will depend on your attitude.
Well, our attitude's all right, finally. Thanks for bringing us to our senses.